If you work with InDesign, you probably already know that your documents can get complicated very quickly. But how can you archive and back up your work safely? Stick around. An InDesign document is never an island. In almost every layout you create in the program, there will be photos and graphics that you'll need to use, and these are all separate from your InDesign file. These files can be located anywhere on your computer or even on a network somewhere. Even if you use no images or graphics in your InDesign document, you will still have fonts that are required for your layout to display correctly. Now, InDesign just remembers where these required files are on your computer and uses them from their original location. So what happens if those files are moved or deleted? Or just not there to begin with? Well, this happens. To avoid this problem, you want to make sure that you have gathered all the necessary links used in your layout along with your InDesign file in the same place, so you can be sure that the document will still open in the future. This is known as a package. InDesign has a built-in feature for just this requirement. The package function collects all the required linked files and fonts used in your layout and copies them for you to an organized set of folders. This package folder can then be safely archived and backed up or supplied to someone else, and the InDesign layout will open and display correctly. So let's have a look at how to create a package. Before packaging, it's a good idea to check that there aren't any problems with the links in your document. You can do this manually by going through the links panel, shown here, to check for any missing or out-of-date links, and also to check for any leftover files placed on the pasteboard. InDesign will not include any files in the package that are on the pasteboard. They need to be on a page somewhere, or you will receive errors for missing links when the package is opened. If you do have any images that you want to keep with the packaged files, but they aren't actually on the page, then you can make InDesign include them by placing them over the slug area or on a hidden layer. Once you've fixed any problems, head up to the File menu and select Package. In the dialog box that opens, you can check the details of your document before proceeding with packaging. While this can sometimes be useful, usually you'll get false errors and no warnings of actual problems, so you're really better off checking your document yourself before getting to this stage. Anyway, when you're ready to proceed, click the Package button. In the File dialog, you need to choose where you want to save your package and also what you want to name the folder. Now, if you like, you can just check every option in the lower section and you'll basically be fine. Obviously, you want to copy any fonts you can. Likewise, any links. That's the whole point of this exercise. Update graphic links just means that InDesign will replace the file path from where each file is located on your system with the new path of the package folder. Document hyphenation exceptions really only matters if you're exchanging the package with someone else and you each have very specific type settings. It's a good idea to include content from hidden layers, and indeed this is another way of keeping your working files in your package. Include IDML will generate a new .idml file to accompany the .indd file in the package folder. This is a good idea for document exchange, but also to have another backup copy just in case. And finally, it may sound wrong, but it's actually wise to not include a PDF at package time. The reason for this is that InDesign will generate the PDF last in the packaging process, after it's copied all the files to the package folder. But then if the PDF fails to generate, InDesign will helpfully declare the package has failed and delete the entire thing. So you have to start all over again. If you're packaging a document with a lot of links, this can take a long time to copy, so it's just less troublesome to create a PDF manually. Okay, so got all that? Good. Hit the Package button to proceed, and InDesign will copy all the required files to their new location. Lastly, remember to manually create a PDF to keep with the package. And that's about it, really. Your package folder can be passed on to anyone else who needs it, or placed into whatever kind of archive or backup system you use. Speaking of which, over time, your collection of archives can grow to be substantial. And most online backup options cap out at around a terabyte, which fills up pretty fast when you're dealing with large collections of archives. So, in the spirit of being a total YouTube cliche, there's an affiliate link down in the description for Backblaze. They're an online backup service that offer unlimited backup quota. And they really do mean unlimited. This is the actual amount of data that is currently backed up on the system this video is being recorded on. That's about 17 terabytes backed up to the cloud. Backblaze offer a 15-day free trial so you can see if it's for you. And if you check down in the description, we have deals from time to time to save you a few bucks if you decide to sign up. But even if you don't choose to sign up, do please make sure you have some kind of backup plan in place. Eventually, one day, you'll need it. Thanks for watching.